Hello folks, so in this video what I want to do is give you a state of union address on where things stand as of today. That is, how are we doing with respect to this different challenges as of September 2012? And I'm sure I'll have to come back and remake this video next year, but I want to give you a feel of where we are with respect to this EUV source, with respect to this optics, and with respect to this resist. So first thing first, in terms of the EUV source, this is the latest source shipped from Kimer, which is one of the leading players in making sort lasers and sources for lithography, based out of San Diego. And this is the latest source that they have shipped in 2012. This is roughly 2 meters high, and it produces a power. They say it produces a power of delivers a power output of 60 watt. So this UV source itself is not that big, but it requires this huge carbon dioxide laser, since the process of generating EUV photons is not the most efficient one. You require this humongous carbon dioxide laser for generating these photons, which can be then used to generate the EUV photons. And this is a humongous thing. The volume of this is the size of 8 conference rooms, and it's so humongous that it's not even placed in the fab. It's placed in this thing as called a sub-fab, which is the floor below the fab, and then you use these set of optics to bring that carbon dioxide laser light into your EUV source and generate your EUV photons. And still, with all this huge size, the power that the EUV source currently achieves is 60 watt. For volume production, what people say, you require a minimum of 100 to 120 watt. So it's still twice short of that target. And so Kimer is one of the leading players, but there are also a lot of small companies, a few startups, which are playing in this EUV source area. And it's still an open challenge. It's that huge, it's a $1 billion market, and whoever, even two guys sitting in a lab can crack it. It's still an open field, I would say. In terms of the optics, this is the latest stepper that is shipped from ASML. ASML, if you don't know, is one of the leading company for making these machines, or what is known as steppers, for lithography. And so here it shows the light, or the light source, UV light source, and you take the light from this UV light source, and it's then bounced off the set of mirrors. Over here you have the mask, which is also a mirror, and then you further bounce it off over these projection lenses, and then you project that light onto this wafer, which is placed over here. And to be noted is that this whole thing works under vacuum, because anything which comes under the way of these UV photons will absorb them. So this whole stepper and all the optics works under vacuum. So if you compare the size of your EUV machine and compare it to the size of your deep UV steppers that currently use, this UV machine has 4 times the size. It has 4 times the size of this deep UV machine. And since it uses all this fancy optics, everything has to work in vacuum. There can't be any vibrations. It just the volume is much higher. And so let's talk about the next challenge, which was the UV resist. Oh, wait a minute. Before we go there, interesting tidbit I want to mention is that, so ASML is one of the companies which leading companies in the field of making these lithography steppers. In fact, that's the majority of their business, or that's the only business they are in. They focus on making these lithography machines, And you can see this focus on lithography being reflected in their logo as well. So if you look carefully, their logo essentially has this alignment marks, and then you have a crosshair which is aligning the second layer to this alignment mark. So I found it, to be pretty amusing, so I wanted to mention it to you. So let's look at the next challenge, which is in terms of this EUV resist. So for a given power, so I mentioned that we are roughly around here in terms of power, we are around 60 watt. We want to go at least here up to 100 or 100 watt in terms of power. So at that power, if you want to enable a throughput of say 100 wafer, that's what a current DUV machine achieves, you need your resist to be of this much sensitivity. So if you look at this black curve, this is a sensitivity of 5 millijoules per centimeter square. Or you want to be, say, let's lax it a little bit, you want to be here, which is a sensitivity of 10 millijoules per centimeter square. So most of the resists which are currently available are around EUV resist have the sensitivity of around 20 to 30 millijoules per centimeter square. So either we get down in terms of resistivity, or we go up in terms of the power we can achieve with our EUV source, so we can still use this high sensitivity resist to enable the same throughput. But that's how where things stand in terms of resist. You still need a further 2x or more improvement in terms of resist sensitivity, so you can achieve this magic number of more than 100 wafer per hour throughput, which is what is required to make EUV commercially feasible.